Hello, Greenlight the Day family, wherever you are in your day, morning, afternoon, or night, I hope that things are going well. It is always a great pleasure to share information with you. I shouldn't say information, I should say life, right? So I read something the other day, and it led me to talk about the value of uselessness. Yes. There is value in uselessness. So let me read you this story. It's a short story. It's a story about a carpenter and his apprentice. A carpenter and his apprentice were talking together through a large, talking and walking together through a large forest. And when they came across a tall, huge, gnarled, old, beautiful oak tree, the carpenter asked his apprentice, "Do you know why this tree is so tall, so huge, so gnarled, so old and beautiful?" The apprentice looked at his master and said, "No, why?" "Well," the carpenter said, "because it is useless. If it had been useful, it would have been cut long ago and made into tables and chairs. But because it is useless, it could grow so tall and so beautiful that you can sit in its shade and relax." There is so much wisdom in this story. I don't even know where to begin. But one of the things that I got out of it was the value of uselessness. You know, we are so concerned with what we do, how we do it. Are we doing it right? Are we doing it to achieve something that we forget the value of just being? We just go throughout our day doing, 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 and forget that our true value is simply just being. We don't have to identify with what we do. That does not have to become the most important thing. And by being useless, we allow ourselves space. And in that space, we can see our true identity, our true gifts. One of the benefits of being useless is solitude. You know, I had talked about solitude, but more in the fact of being, what's the difference between being alone and lonely? And solitude is a great space. There's so many gifts to solitude. I think one of the benefits of solitude is that you get to hear your own authentic voice. As you're changing shapes or whatever adjective you want to use to describe yourself, growing old and gnarled and beautiful, you're spreading your beauty and your love. And you need solitude to do that. A lot of times we're just so concerned with how better we are. Have we grown better? Are we doing better? And we don't give our chance to grow authentically, to hear a voice, to see a light, to warm within, and to have that glow. You know, I can really relate to the story of the tree. I don't see it so much in the summer, but definitely in the winter. I walk past this tree, and it is huge. I mean, the whole trunk is, wow, wide. I can't put my arms around the whole trunk. And it goes all the way up very, very high, and the branches are crooked, and they go left and right, and they're gnarled. And man, it is the most awesome tree. I stand there and I try to figure it out, but I can't. But that's the tree where I feel life speaking to me. And that I can see that there's so many different journeys, so many twists and bends that make this tree beautiful. And I think that that's something that we learn about ourselves in solitude. We're not going to be able to get that if we're constantly comparing our life and doing and going. That stillness gives us permission to grow. And I just wanted to end this with what the writer of the book, Henry J.M. Nouwen, I can never do this right, and it's called Out of Solitude, Three Meditations on the Christian Life. And it doesn't have to be a Christian life. It could be, I would use the word authentic, or meaning, life of meaning. But let me read to you what he wrote. A life without a lonely place, That is, a life without a quiet center easily becomes destructive. When we cling to the result of our actions as our only way of self-identification, then we become possessive and defensive and tend to look at our fellow human beings more as enemies to be kept at a distance than as friends with whom we share the gifts of life. In solitude, we discover that our life is not a possession to be defended, but a gift to be shared. It is there we recognize that the healing words we speak are not just our own, but are given to us, that the love we can express is part of a greater love, and that the new life we bring forth is not a property to cling to, but a gift to be received.